welcome to a new episode of English class. Okay, in the previous class we discussed about the second chapter and we completed the comprehensive work from the text. I hope all of you enjoyed this chapter and you studied it very well, and there will be a test paper for you recently. Okay, let us start the third chapter. Our third chapter is strength versus size. First you study these two words, strength, S-T-R-E-N-G-T-H. Say with me, say the spelling loudly, S-T-R-E-N-G-T-H, strength, S-T-R-E-N-G-T-H, strength versus size, S-I-Z-E, size, S-I-Z-E, size, strength versus size. Strength means what is strength? Strong. We always say strong. I am strong. You are saying I am strong. There is an ad from the TV. I am strength. Boost is the secret of my energy. There the child is showing his strength. Strength means shakti. Strength versus size. S-I-Z-E. Size means valipam. Size. S-I-Z-E, that means it is small size or big size word. Strength versus size. What is the name of our chapter? Strength versus size. Can you read this? Strength, S-T-R-E-N-G-T-H, strength versus size, S-I-Z-E. You take page number 22. Take page number 22 of your text. Look at the picture. Do you know these animals? Write their names. There are six pictures are given. Six pictures are given in the text, and there are six columns under each picture. Under each picture there is a column, and you write the names of the animals in the column. Okay? Do you see this? You write the names of animals in the column. The first one is lion. You write capital letters. L-I-O-N. Lion. The first picture is that of a lion. L-I-O-N. Lion. The first picture is that of a lion. The second is cheetah. C-H-E-E-T-A-H. Cheetah. C-H-E-E-T-A-H. Cheetah. Lion. Cheetah. The next one. Cat. C A T, cat. C A T, cat. Then deer. D E E R, deer. D E E R, deer. Next one is elephant. E L E P H A N T. Elephant. E L E P H A N T. Elephant. The last picture is monkey. M O N K E Y. Monkey. Look here. L I O N. Lion. Say with me. L I O N. Lion. Next one, cheetah. The fastest running animal is cheetah. C-H-E-E-T-A-H. Cheetah. Spelling C-H-E-E-T-A-H. Cheetah. Then third one is cat. Spell the word loudly and write in your test. C-A-T. Cat. C A T, cat. Next one, deer. D E E R, deer. D E E R, deer. Next one, elephant. E L E P H A N T, elephant. E L E P H A N T, elephant. Next one, monkey. M-O-N-K-E-Y, monkey. M-O-N-K-E-Y, monkey. Do you finish? Yes, I hope you finish. Then, Let us move on to the chapter. I will read it once more very slowly. You slowly, you carefully listen to the text, page number 22. Shere Khan, the king of the jungle, was taking a nap outside his den. He had just finished a delicious meal and was very happy. He licked his mouth with his tongue to clean it. Suddenly, he felt a tickling sensation on his neck. He shrugged his shoulders. Now, the sensation traveled from his neck to his shoulder and then to his back. What was it? He tried to scratch it away, but his paw closed around something soft and wriggly. He brought it close to his eyes. It was Mangu, the naughty mouse. This was a very interesting story. Do you like watching cartoons? Yes, I know all of you like watching cartoons. Shere Khan. Whose story is this? This is the story of Shere Khan, the king of jungles. Who is the king of jungles? Forest. Who is the king of forest? Lion is the king of forest. Shere Khan. Listen here. Yes, H E R K H A N. Shere Khan. Say the word with me. Yes, H E R K H A N. Shere Khan. Shere Khan, the king of jungle. Say the word jungle. J U N G L E. Jungle. J U N G L E. Jungle. Do you see this word? J-U-N-G-L-E. Jungle. Was taking a nap. Taking. T-A-K-I-N-G. Taking. T-A-K-I-N-G. Taking. Spell the word. T-A-K-I-N-G. Taking. A nap. N-A-P. Nap. What is it? Nap. N-A-P. Nap. Shere Khan, the king of jungle, was taking a nap outside his den. D-E-N. Den. These are the words in the first line. Listen to these words. How do you read these words? Shere Khan. Spelling S-H-E-R-K-H-A-N. Shere Khan. S-H-E-R-K-H-A-N. Shere Khan. Who is Shere Khan? Shere Khan is the king of jungles. Jungle means forest. What is the meaning of jungle? Forest. Shere Khan is the king of jungle. King of jungle. Shere Khan is the king of jungle. Who is the king of jungle? Lion. Lion is the king of jungle. Here, Shere Khan is a lion. Shere Khan is a lion. Shere Khan, the king of jungle, was taking a nap. What is the meaning of nap? N-A-P, nap, meaning short sleep. After having lunch, we are in the habit of taking a short sleep. That is called a nap. Nap means short sleep. Nap means short sleep. S-H-O-R-T, short. S-L-E-E-P, sleep. Do you understand what is nap? Nap means short sleep. Here, this is the story of a lion. The lion's name is Shere Khan. What is the name of the lion? Shere Khan. Shere Khan, the king of jungle. Jungle means forest. Jungle meaning forest. F-O-R-E-S-T. Forest. Shere Khan is the name of a lion. Name of a lion. L-I-O-N. Lion. L-I-O-N. Lion. Say with me. Shere Khan, the name of a lion. Shere Khan is the name of a lion. Jungle means forest. Jungle means forest. Then taking, he is having. Taking means having. Taking means having. Now, short sleep. Then den. Den means the shelter of lion. The house of lion. jungle was taking a nap outside his den. Who is Shere Khan? Shere Khan is a lion. What was he doing? He was taking a nap. He is having a short sleep. Where is he sleeping? He is sleeping outside the den. What is den? Den is the home of Shere Khan. Okay, is it clear? Shere Khan is taking a short sleep after his lunch. He is sleeping outside his den. He is sleeping outside his den. Is it clear? Yes, let us move on to the next line. Shere Khan, the king of jungle, was taking a nap outside his den. He had just finished a delicious meal. He had just finished. Finished means, what is the meaning of finished? F-I-N-I-S-H-E-D. How do we read this word? Finished. F-I-N-I-S-H-E-D. Finished. What is the meaning of finished? Completed. Finished means completed. Finished means completed. Shere Khan was sleeping outside his house. What is the house of a lion called? The house of a lion is called den. He is sleeping outside his den. Then he had just finished. That means he completed his lunch just now. Only a few minutes ago. He had just finished a delicious meal. What is the meal? It was a delicious one. Delicious. What is the meaning of delicious? Listen to the spelling of delicious. D-E-L-I-C-I-O-U-S. What is the meaning of delicious? Tasty. Delicious means tasty. What is the meaning of delicious? Tasty. Delicious meal. Meal means food. He had his delicious meal and was very happy. Shere Khan became very happy. If we are having our delicious lunch, we feel some happiness. We feel some happiness. Like that, here Shere Khan is very happy. Why is Shere Khan happy? Shere Khan is happy because he had his lunch, that means delicious lunch, a few minutes ago. That means he had just completed his meal. And he licked his mouth with his tongue to clean it. What was he doing there? He licked his mouth. Licked, L-I-C-K-E-D, licking. What is licked? What is the meaning of licked? Like this. He is licking. Licking his mouth using his tongue. T-O-N-G-U-E is pronounced as tongue. Licked, L-I-C-K-E-D, licked. L-I-C-K-E-D, licked. He licked his mouth with his tongue to clean it. Why did he lick his mouth? He licked his mouth to clean his mouth. After what are we doing? We are washing our mouth after our meals. We are washing our mouth using water after our meals. Here, Shere Khan. Who is Shere Khan? Shere Khan is the lion. He is licking his mouth to clean it. Suddenly, he felt a tickling sensation. Tickling. T-I-C-K-L-I-N-G. Tickling. T-I-C-K-L-I-N-G. Tickling. What is the meaning of tickling? Tickling. If somebody tickled you, what will you do? We will laugh. Tickling means ikkliyakla. Tickling. Tickling sensation. Sensation means a feeling. S-E-N-S-A-T-I-O-N. Sensation. S-E-N-S-A-T-I-O-N. Sensation. Feeling. Sensation means feeling. Tickling feeling. He got a tickling feeling. Shere Khan was sleeping and suddenly he felt the tickling sensation on his neck. Where was the tickling sensation? He feels a tickling sensation in his neck. He shrugged his shoulders. Shrugged means like this. He shrugged his shoulders. Kudega. He shrugged. S-H-R-U-G-G-E-D. Shrugged. S-H-R-U-G-G-E-D. Shrugged his shoulders. S-H-O-U-L-D-E-R-S. Shoulders. He shrugged his shoulders. He shrugged his shoulders. This is the paragraph, first paragraph. Okay, I will read it once more. You listen carefully to the test. Sher Khan, the king of jungle, was taking a nap outside his den. He had just finished a delicious meal and was very happy. He licked his mouth with his tongue to clean it. Suddenly, he felt a tickling sensation on his neck. He shrugged his shoulders. Do you study how to read it? Yes, you take a video of reading this paragraph and send it to me. Sher Khan, the king of jungles, was taking a nap outside his den. He had just finished a delicious meal and was very happy. He licked his mouth with his tongue to clean it. Suddenly, he felt a tickling sensation on his neck. She shrugged his shoulders. Okay, then we will go to the next paragraph. Now the sensation traveled from his neck to his shoulder. Now the sensation is traveling from his neck to the shoulders. What happened? He got a sensation in his neck and now the sensation traveled from his neck to the shoulders. This is shoulders and then to his back. Then where it go? It traveled from his neck to the shoulders and then to his back. It is moving. The sensation is moving. He feel a sensation and the sensation is moving. At first it begins from the neck to the shoulders and now it moves on to his back. What is it? He tried to scratch it away. What is it? He don't know what is it. Then the lion is thinking, Sher Khan is thinking, what is it? What is the sensation? He tried, T-R-I-E-D, tried. T-R-I-E-D, tried. He tried to scratch it. Scratch it means move it away, scratch it. He tried to scratch it away, but his paw, P-A-W, paw means the legs of the lion. Paw, P-A-W, paw. Paw means the leg, that means this part is called a paw. This part of the hand is called a paw. His paw closed around something soft and wriggly. What happened then? Here, Sher Khan tries to scratch away the sensation. Then he feels something soft and wriggly. Soft, S-O-F-T, soft and wriggly, W-R-I. Wriggly, W-R-I-G-G-L-Y. Wriggly means moving in a special manner, wriggly. He tried to, who is the he here? Sher Khan. Sher Khan tried to scratch it away, but his paw closed around something soft and wriggly. He brought it close to eyes. Then he moved his paws behind him and take the sensation and it closed to his eyes. He hold it close to his eyes. Sher Khan hold the thing close to his eyes. It was Mangu the naughty mouse. Who was the sensation? It was Mangu. Listen the spelling. M-A-N-K-U, Mangu. Who is Mangu? Mangu is a naughty mouse. N-A-U-G-S-T-Y, naughty. Naughty means, what is the meaning of naughty? Vigridi. Naughty mouse, M-O-U-S-T, mouse. What is the meaning of mouse? Mouse, L. It is a naughty mouse. What is the name of the naughty mouse? Mangu. What is the name of the naughty mouse? Mangu, M-A-N-K-U. Okay, I will read that paragraph once more. You listen to the text. Now the sensation traveled from the neck to his shoulder. And then to his back. The sensation, at first he feels the sensation in the neck, then it goes to the shoulders and now it is moving to his back. What was it? He tried to scratch it away, but his paw closed around something soft and wriggly. Something soft, S-O-F-T, soft and W-R-I-G-G-L-Y, wriggly. He brought it close to his eyes. He brought the thing from his with his hand and brought it close to his eyes. It was Mangu the naughty mouse. Who was the sensation? Who created a sensation? The sensation was created by Mango. Who was the Mango? Mango was a naughty mouse. Mango was a naughty mouse. Let us look at the tough words from these two paragraphs. L-I-C-K-E-D, licked. How do we read it? Licked. L-I-C-K-E-D, licked. Next one, tickling. T-I-C-K-L-I-N-G, tickling. You say the word with me. T-I-C-K-L-I-N-G, tickling. Next one, sensation. S-E-N-S-A-T-I-O-N, sensation. S-E-N-S-A-T-I-O-N, sensation. Then next word is shrugged. S-H-R-U-G-G-E-D, it is shrugged. It is shrugged. S-H-R-U-G-G-E-D, shrugged. Then shoulders. S-H-O-U-L-D-E-R-S, shoulders. It is pronounced as shoulders. Then T-R-I-E-D, tried. T-R-I-E-D, tried. Then paw, P-A-W, paw. Then soft, S-O-F-T, soft. It is soft and wriggly. W-R-I-G-G-L-Y, wriggly. It is not wriggly, it is wriggly. W silent there. W-R-I-G-G-L-Y, wriggly. Then monkey, M-A-N-K-U, monkey. N-A-U-G-S-T-Y, naughty. It is pronounced as naughty. N-A-U-G-S-T-Y, naughty. M-O-U-S-E, mouse. Okay, I'll read it once more. Licked, tickling, sensation. Then shrugged, shoulders. Tried, paw, soft. Wriggly, mango, naughty, mouse. These are the tough words from the first two paragraphs. I'll read that paragraph once more. You please listen to the text. Sher Khan, the king of the jungle, was taking a nap outside his den. He had just finished a delicious meal and was very happy. He licked his mouth with his tongue to clean it. Suddenly, he felt a tickling sensation on his back. He shrugged his shoulders. Now, the sensation traveled from his neck to his shoulder and then to his back. What was it? He tried to scratch it away, but his paw closed around something soft and wriggly. He brought it close to his eyes. It was Mangu, the naughty mouse. Okay, do you know how to read it? Then let us go to the next paragraph. Please, please, Sher Khan uncle, I'm sorry. Let me go. I will help you someday. He pleaded. What was the sentence? Please, please, Uncle Sher Khan, here the mouse is very naughty. Mango mouse is very naughty like you. You are naughty children. Is it correct? Yes, you are very naughty children. And here the mango, the naughty mouse, begged the lion. Sher Khan begged the lion. Please, please, Uncle Sher Khan, please let me go. Please, Uncle Sher Khan, please let me go. Let me go means allow me to go. Don't hurt me. Please allow me to go. Sher Khan, the mouse pleaded. Pleaded means begged. Begged. Please, please, Sher Khan uncle, I'm sorry. I'm very sorry. I tickled you. I'm sorry for that. Let me go. I will help you someday. If you let me go now, I will help you someday. He pleaded. Someday means in some occasion when you are in need, I will help you someday. So you will please let me go. Can you help? Let me go? Asked the mango to the lion, Sher Khan. Please, please, Sher Khan uncle, the spelling of please, P-L-E-A-S-E, please, please, uncle, U-N-C-L-E, U-N-C-L-E, uncle, Sher Khan, I'm sorry, sorry, spelling of sorry, S-O-R-Y, sorry, please, please, uncle Sher Khan, I'm sorry, let me go, I will help you someday, someday, S-O-M-E-D-A-Y, someday, I will help you someday. He pleaded, P-L-E-A-D-E-D, pleaded, P-L-E-A-D-E-D, pleaded. Look at the word, P-L-E-A-S-E, please. Always we are saying, please, I'm sorry, but you don't, you know the spelling, do you know the spelling? P-L-E-A-S-E, please, P-L-E-A-S-E. uncle, 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 uncle. Sorry, SORRY, sorry. Someday, SOMEDAY, someday. Pleaded, 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 pleaded. Please, please share an angle. I'm sorry. Let me go. I will help you someday. He pleaded. Ha ha ha. Shere Khan roared. What did Shere Khan do? Shere Khan is the lion. He is the king of jungles. He roared. The sound of lion is called a roaring. R-O-A-R. Look at the new word. R-O-A-R-E-D. Roared. R-O-A-R-E-D. Roared. R-O-A-R-E-D. Roared. That means the lion made a roaring sound. The sound of a lion is roar. R-O-A-R. Ha ha ha. Shere Khan roared. How can a little mouse help me? He is in a surprise. He asked in a surprise tone. How can a little mouse? You are very little. How can you help me? I am the king of the jungle. I am the king of the forest. I am a lion. I am Shere Khan, the king of jungle. How can you, little mouse? How can you help me? How can you help me? Shere Khan wanted to sleep. So he let go Mungo off, warning him not to trouble him again. What did Shere Khan do? Shere Khan wanted to sleep. Shere Khan wanted to sleep because his stomach is full. His stomach is full because he had a delicious meal. Shere Khan had a delicious meal, so his stomach is full. So he wanted to sleep and he is in a happy mood. So he wanted to sleep. W-A-N-T-E-D. Wanted. W-A-N-T-E-D. T-E-D, wanted. Say the spelling and word. W-A-N-T-E-D, wanted. Shere Khan wanted to sleep. So he let go Mungo off. So he let Mungo to go away from there. So he let means allowed. Let, allowed, allow. So he let Mungo go away from there, warning him not to trouble him again. But Shere Khan warned him, give a warning. That means he give a warning to him, don't trouble me again. Trouble means make discomfort. Trouble means make discomfort. Shere Khan wanted to sleep, so he let go Mungo off. Warning. W-A-R-N-I-N-G. W-A-R-N-I-N-G. Warning him not to trouble. T-R-O-U-B-L-E. Trouble him again. A-G-A-I-N. Again. Again, these are the new words from this line. Shere Khan wanted to sleep, so he let go Mungo off from there. So he let go Mungo off, warning him. He gave a warning. Who warned the mouse? Shere Khan warned the mouse, give him a warning not to trouble him again. What was the warning given to the Mungo, given to the mouse? The warning given to Mungo was not to trouble him again. You go now and not trouble me again and not trouble me again. Give him a warning. I'll read that once more. Please, please, Shere Khan uncle. I'm sorry. Let me go. I will help you someday. He pleaded. Ha ha ha. Shere Khan roared. How can a little mouse help me? Shere Khan wanted to sleep. So he let go Mungo off, warning him not to trouble him again. Look at the tough words from this question. R-O-A-R-D. Roared. How do we read it? R-O-A-R-D. Roared. Then warned. W-A-N-T-E-D. Warned. Next word is warning. W-A-R-N-I-N-G. Warning. W-A-R-N-I-N-G. Warning. Next word is trouble. T-R-O-U-B-L-E. Trouble. T-R-O-U-B-L-E. Trouble. Next word. Again. A-G-A-I-N. Again. It is again. Then let us move on to the next paragraph. Shere Khan wanted to sleep, so he let go Mungo off, warning him not to trouble him again. Thank you uncle, exclaimed Mungo, jumping with joy. What did the naughty mouse do? Thank you uncle, exclaimed Mungo, exclaimed, E-X-C-L-A-I-M-E-D, He don't think that Shere Khan allow him to go, but he pleaded. He is a naughty mouse. So he pleaded Shere Khan. Shere Khan was in a happy mood, and he let Mangu go off from there, warning him not to trouble me again. But being excited, being in an exclaimed tone, he said thank you to the lion. He said thank you to the lion. What was he saying? Thank you, uncle, exclaimed Mangu, jumping with joy. Here is a new word for you. Jumping, J-U-M-P-I-N-G. Jumping, J-U-M-P-I-N-G. Jumping, J-U-M-P-I-N-G. Jumping. Okay, look at the text from the very beginning. Shere Khan, the king of the jungle, was taking a nap outside his den. He had just finished a delicious meal and was very happy. He licked his mouth with his tongue to clean it. Suddenly, he felt a tickling sensation on his neck. He shrugged his shoulders. Now the sensation traveled from his neck to his shoulder and then to his back. What was it? He tried to scratch it away, but his paw closed around something soft and wriggly. He brought it close to his eyes. It was Mangu, the naughty mouse. Please, Shere Khan uncle, I'm sorry. Let me go. I'll help you someday, he pleaded. Ha ha ha, Shere Khan roared. How can a little mouse help me? Shere Khan wanted to sleep. So he let go Mangu off, warning him not to trouble him again. Thank you, uncle, exclaimed Mangu, jumping with great joy. He is jumping with joy. Okay, today we can stop here and let us continue in the next class. Do you like this story? Do you like the story of the lion and the Mangu? Yes, I hope all of you enjoyed this part, and you read the text so many times as possible. You see the video fully 2 or 3 times and you read the text, and it will be easy for you to study the lesson. Okay, let us stop here. See you tomorrow.